The Microsoft Windows is one of the most widely used operating systems in the world, but its user interface hasn't changed for a long time, especially since Windows 8. I get it that the Sun Valley update is going to bring a host of changes, but its release date is nowhere on the horizon yet. And I understand that, like me, most of you are also sick of these change listeners and searching for some ways to change certain things to make the Windows look more modern, or at least different, in a pleasant manner. Well, search no further, because I'm going to show you 5 free apps that can instantly give your good old Windows a fresh new look and make it more contemporary with very little effort and time. If this is your first time here, or if you haven't already, then I request you to please subscribe to this channel, hit on the bell icon, and share this video with your friends. So without further delay, let's get into the video. My name is Jitesh, and you are watching JIOLOJI. The first app that I want to talk about is called Modern Flyouts. As the name says, this app will replace the default Windows Flyout UIs like the volume and brightness sliders with a bit more modern design. This app requires no installation hassles, it can be easily installed from the Microsoft Store. And after installation, the modern flyouts will take the place of the default brightness and volume sliders. Apart from sliders, it can also show other Windows UI elements and notifications like caps lock, num slot, scroll lock, airplane mode, etc., most of which are not usually there in Windows by default. Inside the app settings, we can switch between the default Windows flyouts or the modern flyouts, or it even allows us to completely turn the flyouts off. This app also has a variety of customization options as well in the settings page. You can set the theme of the flyouts or the app settings separately to either light or dark, and you can also choose the opacity of the flyouts to your liking. Another thing you can customize is the position of the flyouts. It can be automatically positioned to the center or 8 other places, or be manually placed anywhere you please on the display. Or if you have a multi-display setup, you can select the display in which the flyout needs to be shown as well. And lastly, there is also a background media playback flyout that will show a mini media player in which you can change tracks and shuffle music. The next app is called Taskbar X. This app is really simple, and all it does is moving the app icons to the center of the taskbar. It can be argued that the idea is like the dot in the macOS, but this is a simple tweak on the real taskbar instead of a separate app. It can be downloaded and installed easily from the Microsoft Store, and it's also available to download from the official website and GitHub. The links are given separately in the description below. The store version is only available for purchase at a price of ₹79, but the app can be downloaded from the sites for free. These are both the same app, and the only advantage of the paid app is that it gets automatic updates, whereas the other two needs to be manually downloaded and installed every time an update is released. To use it for free, you just need to download the files and extract it to a folder in your PC. And from there, just open the taskbar.exe, and you're done. To further customize, you can open the taskbar configurator, and you again get a host of options to choose from. The taskbar styles can be changed from default to transparent, to opaque, to blur, etc. And you can even use the color and transparency of your choice. The icons will rearrange according to the number of running apps in the taskbar, and all the Windows taskbar settings still works perfectly. The animation speed and the offsets can be changed in the app settings, and there are options to hide the start button and the tray area to have a completely immersed look. In my opinion, the transparent style looks the best, as it looks like the icons are just floating on top of the wallpaper. And it looks better with all the taskbar buttons hidden with dark or gradient wallpapers. You can restart the taskbar X if you encounter any errors, or stop the taskbar X completely to get back the original Windows taskbar. Also note that this app will work only on Windows 10 with a build number of 1709 or higher. I'm sure you're bored with the Windows Explorer that's basic interface hasn't changed since ages ago. Well, this app could really be the solution to that. There are a handful of File Explorer alternatives out there for Windows, but this app is the one that really looks the part. In fact, this looks so well suited to the modern Windows idea that I can't help but wish that if Microsoft itself could create something like this, or even buy this and implement in the future Windows update. Anyway, we already know this won't happen, so no more wishful thinking. Back to the app, like I already said, this really looks like a Windows Explorer from the near future, but the app as expected is not without its downsides and glitches, which I'll talk about in a bit. There are lots of UI similarities between this and the Start Explorer. The home screen is like a My Computer page on the Explorer, where we can see our disk drives and user folders. On the left, there is a navigation pane, and we can pin our own folders there if we choose so. We have the dark and light themes here, which goes along well with the overall Windows theme. We also have this translucent effect on the navigation pane like the latest Windows apps, which I must admit is really beautiful. Going inside the Windows, we will come to see flat icons, and there is no option to change the default icon in the properties. There are different layout modes too that you can choose from to customize the icon size inside the Windows. Another useful feature in this app is the tab and pane browser. We can open a folder in a new window, or if we choose so, a new tab or a new pane. The pane browsing is going to make the file transferring from one window to another much easier, as we can just drag and drop without hunting for the other window. The tab browsing is also very useful, that lets us to close the app and open it later to see the previous tabs still open there. The context menu also contains almost all the functions that we can find in our Start Explorer menu. Going into the settings, you will find a lot of options to customize this app. However, the chances are that an inexperienced user may find these options rather overwhelming. The app is mostly stable, though it crashed many times with me. The file transfer operation doesn't have a proper UI, and we'll need to check here on the lower part of the window to see them if there is any. The file and folder properties are really basic, and there are nothing we can do there as opposed to the Start Explorer properties. Anyway, if you're someone who likes modern UI, this is a must-use app. What makes Power Toys app different from other apps is that it's made by Microsoft itself, mainly for developers and power users. Instead of trying to make Windows look modern, this app is more inclined towards providing extra functionalities to those tools that are already there in Windows. The app is available for Windows 95, XP and Windows 10, and can be downloaded from Microsoft website as well as GitHub page. Please note that PowerToys could have different functionalities in Windows 95 and XP versions. The one I am showing here today is only for the Windows 10. There are a handful of tools, and with the ability to customize them in the very specific ways that suits you, it can completely change the way you use and experience Windows in many ways. I'm not going into detailed explanations of every tools here, although most are self-explanatory. If you're having trouble in understanding your tool, there is a small thumbnail given on the right side on which if you click, it will take you to the Microsoft help page where all the tools are explained in a very detailed manner. The good thing about this app is that it will let you turn on only those tools that you want to use and completely turn off the ones that you don't. What I want to use and show you here today are two tools called Fancy Zones and Power Toys Run. Fancy Zones is actually a Windows Manager utility that helps you snap and arrange Windows into a number of custom zones instead of Windows' default layouts of just 7 zones. Inside the layout editor, you can select any layout templates or create your own according to the kind of work that you do. All you have to do is create a custom layout, select grid or canvas, and then define the Windows positions and numbers as you need, and click on save. Now if you press the shift key while dragging a window, the fancy zones can be seen, and you can simply drop the window to the preferred zone. You can basically create any number of zones, but I advise against creating small ones, because most windows have a minimum size to maintain, below which it won't shrink and may not fit into your zone. Power Toys Run is a run and search tool both in one with a fresh interface. If you assign the keys Windows and S as a shortcut for it, it will basically replace your default Windows search. You can press the shortcut keys anytime, even while using other apps. It will pop up as a floating search bar, which is really cool looking. Inside the settings, you can choose the number of search results that you want to show up. If you have a multi-monitor setup, you can also choose the display on which the search bar needs to pop up. And you can customize the search bar theme to either light or dark. And this app is so well developed that it can not only show search results for files and apps, but can also execute Windows shell and system commands, search URLs directly, and can even be used as a calculator. Lively Wallpaper is another free app that's available in the Microsoft Store. And it's great to see that such an app with so many levels of customization and features comes completely free of cost. Most wallpapers included uses real-time simulations to generate, so it supports all display resolutions and aspect ratios. This wallpaper app is one of the most fun apps of the lot, and it is as simple as it is complex. Well, the simple part is that you can just open the app and click on the available wallpaper, and you're set. That's also where the simple part ends. When you start customizing the wallpapers, you will come to know about the endless settings combinations to make the wallpapers look almost exactly as you want them to be. Most wallpapers have their own customization settings. The app will be running in the background and can be easily accessed from the tray area if you want to quickly change or close live wallpapers. Let me go through some of the available wallpapers and their settings briefly. First, we have an eternal light wallpaper, which is a sunset in the background with its reflection in the sea. You can right click on it to see a preview of the wallpaper before applying and see the options to customize the wallpaper too. Inside the customization, you can change the given values and see the wallpaper updating in real time. You can change the values for color and speed of the waves here, but every wallpapers have their own custom options that may be completely different from this one. For example, the next one here is called Fluids. This one has a lot of simulation settings which we can change, like quality, simulation resolution, density, velocity, pressure and much more. This wallpaper generates fluid dynamics based on where our cursor is, and we can generate lots of cool effects using the settings. There's also a music visualizer in this wallpaper, which again is really cool. The periodic table wallpaper could be useful for students. Then there is raindrop effects, triangle patterns, waves, matrix codes, etc. But the real deal is that we can add any website URL, like my YouTube channel here, and set it as a wallpaper, which is also interactable. How cool is that? Lastly, you can also make a wallpaper out of any video file that you can add from your computer. You'll also be able to download wallpaper files from online and add it to the library too. Inside the app settings, you have the options to pause or kill the wallpaper while using a full screen app or when running low on battery. And based on the kind of wallpaper, the app is going to use noticeable amount of resources too. So I advise against using it if your PC is already slow or has not a lot of RAM and CPU to spare. That's that about it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please subscribe to this channel and make sure you hit on the bell icon so that you won't miss my upcoming videos. Please don't forget to leave a thumbs up and your valuable comments and suggestions down below as well. I thank you for watching and hope to see you again soon in my next video. Until then, ciao.